Let us pray. Out of your word and into our hearts, may your truth take root and grow until we're overwhelmed by your love and by your grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Natasha Bedingfield wrote her hit song, Unwritten, with Daniel Brisebois and Wayne Rodriguez. The creative process involved combining their personal experiences, a special family connection, and organic musical elements to create a song that became the most played song on the radio in 2006. Listen to a little bit of Unwritten. This song began as a poem that she wrote for her brother on his 14th birthday. She couldn't be there, and so she sent this poem instead. She tried to capture the idea of a young person's future as a blank page waiting to be written, but at the same time naming the pressure that young people face to try and plan their whole future out before their lives have even really begun. She wanted to convey the importance of embracing the unknown. Over 2 days, Bedingfield and Brisebois worked on the song. Brisebois' husband, Nick Lashley, added the opening guitar riff, and Wayne Rodriguez created the drum track. Bedingfield's sister and a friend provided the gospel interlude that really makes the song somewhat of an anthem. And I love the powerful statement, no one can feel it for you, only you can let it in. Our lives are ours to live, and we're responsible for the choices that we make. Brisebois was a successful child actress in the 1970s, and later a member of the band The New Radicals. But all of that was in her past. Since then, she had not experienced very much success at all, and really kind of found herself down and out. And so she said as she was working on her part of the song that she was writing words that she needed to hear to help her pick herself back up. Unwritten touched listeners on a deep level. The success of the song lies in its ability to authentically encourage listeners to embrace the unwritten possibilities in their lives and to trust that their future will get better no matter what lies ahead. This theme of venturing into the unknown resonates with the disciples' experience when Jesus sent them out two by two. He sent them into the world, though, with only the barest of essentials, but he also said that he would send his power with them as they went. Their future was truly unwritten, filled with uncertainty, but still with a divine purpose. And Mark wrote about their experience this way. Jesus called for the 12 disciples and sent them out in pairs. He gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey except a walking stick, no bread, no bags, and no money in their belts. He told them to wear sandals, but not to put on two shirts. He said, whatever house you enter, remain there until you leave that place. Meaning, if you get invited to a nicer house while you're in that village, don't go there. Stay in the same place until it's time to move on to the next village. Jesus sends him out with no specific guidance other than go. Oh, but by the way, don't take anything with you. Whatever they have relied on in the past will be useless to them as God leads them into the future. When we follow Jesus, we too must leave our baggage behind. I don't mean suitcases or luggage, but I mean the unresolved emotion that interferes with our relationships or our ability to function in fulfilling our responsibilities. And some of this emotional baggage is past trauma. Now let me say, trauma is real and it must be dealt with, because if we leave it unresolved, it always comes back to harm us. But other emotional unresolved emotions include regret, guilt, fear of rejection. Many people face self-doubt, lacking confidence in their abilities or their worth. There's unresolved grief. There are trust issues because of the betrayals that we have faced in life. But there's also unhealthy ideas about God that can be emotional baggage, where we've held a persistent belief in controlling, manipulative, or vindictive images of God. We've seen the havoc that all of this emotional baggage wreaks on our lives, diminishing them and taking away from the joy that God intends for us to have. What we must do is we must let go of these destructive emotions and move forward with the confidence that God is with us. We are not our past. We have the present, and with God going on this journey with us, then we can continue to grow and develop into the future in a way that God would have us to grow and develop. But we've got to learn to let go. In our gospel lesson for today, Jesus' hometown crowd confronted him with some of the baggage in his life. Mark recorded it this way. Jesus came to his hometown. On the Sabbath, he began to teach in the synagogue. Many who heard him were surprised. Where did this man get all this? What's this wisdom he's been given? What about the powerful acts accomplished through him? Isn't this the carpenter? Isn't he Mary's son and the brother of James, Joseph, Judas, and Simon? Aren't his sisters here with us? And I can imagine that several in Nazareth may have been married to his sisters. They were repulsed by him and fell into sin. Now, Nazareth was a small community, and everybody knew Jesus and his family. They revealed their true feelings about Jesus when they referred to him as Mary's son, not in the customary way, as Joseph's son. What they were saying is, he's nothing more than the son of the girl who got pregnant before she got married. And the assumption was that he would never amount to anything, and that's the baggage that they carried despite seeing Jesus do these astounding things. The scripture, Jesus responds to them in saying, prophets are honored everywhere except in their hometowns, among their relatives and their own households. He could not do any miracles there, except that he placed his hands on a few sick people and healed them. He was appalled by their disbelief. Then Jesus traveled through the surrounding villages teaching, and the assumption is that he was able to do miracles where he went. The reason that Jesus couldn't do miracles in Nazareth is because the people didn't believe. Jesus will never force a miracle on anyone. There were some folks there who did believe, and the scripture indicates that they were able to be healed by Jesus. But the majority rejected him. So it's in this context of rejection that Jesus tells his disciples to leave their baggage behind. He says not to let their past define them. Their futures are unwritten and the possibilities are endless. I think it's important for us to recognize that God is a God of infinite possibilities. No matter how much you think you may have messed up, you can never mess up enough to keep God from redeeming your life and making something better of it. You're just not that powerful. But God is a God of infinite possibilities who can take even the greatest mess that we can get ourselves into and turn it into something that is for our good. Jesus doesn't say that life will be easy because there will always be those who reject us. But he gave this advice to his disciples. If a place doesn't welcome you or listen to you, shake the dust off your feet as you leave as a witness against them. Now, I've been studying this passage of Scripture for several weeks now, and I can't believe that I didn't think of Taylor Swift's song, Shake It Off, to go along with this. I don't know what was going on in my head. But she wrote Shake It Off about how she learned to deal with all the rumors, lies, and innuendos she faced when she became popular. She said this, "I've learned a tough lesson in the past couple of years. People can say whatever they want about you at any time, and you can't control that. The only thing we can control is our reaction. You can either let it get to you or just shake it off." And that's what Jesus was telling the disciples. Just shake it off. Now, he didn't sound like this, but I think he would approve of Taylor's version of Shake It Off. Can move if you want to. I know some of you really want to. I go on too many dates, but I can't make them stay. At least that's what people say. That's what people say. But I keep cruising. Can't stop, won't stop moving. It's like I got this music in my mind saying it's gonna be alright. Cause the players gonna play, play. Jesus knows that the haters are going to hate, no matter what. And so we just need to shake it off. We need to let it go. If the disciples could leave their baggage behind and move into the future, trusting that wherever God sent them, that God would go with them and provide everything they need, then they could do great things. And the beautiful thing is that in this scripture passage, we see that they are able to do great things. According to Mark, the disciples went out and proclaimed that people should change their hearts and lives. They cast out many demons and they anointed many sick people with olive oil and healed them. They were successful. We can trust that wherever God sends us and whatever God asks us to do, God goes with us and God ensures success. I can't wait to see what God has in store for us if we can leave our baggage behind and trust that He is with us every step of the journey. God has a beautiful unwritten future awaiting us if we'll just let go and move on. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen and amen.